copies by Jean. Densely induced morphological transformation of galaxies around the Hubble sequence.
This is my first time in Russia, and I'm very excited to be here because 35 years ago, my own parents came to the former Soviet Union to attend university. So I have been familiar with a lot of the images and language.
The stars, what they actually do in the
when it encounters, because of the spaceship, it turns out the sign of the spaceship, it makes the disk evolve with time. As a result, the street bar is also very important for the second. So this, you start to see more electrical and early type gap. That previous equation turns out to quantitatively fit the age. Like I have said, starting from the early work of John Formany. So this is the calculated phase shift from the two curves. Examples of it we have shown in the poster that I have orbits. That's not accounted for in a top-down control. It's almost like a directive sum with the torque we have on the spiral. That's the contrast that is on the inner edge goes to the outer. The study of self-organized phenomenon is still in its infancy, even though across many disciplines people have found many structures of this property, such as chemical clocks, which is studied by the Frigogino, convection flow in atmosphere, this is the Bernard instability, and lasers, which is a synergetic book is about. But in the case of galaxies, the cell gravity actually created a more complex situation than all these other type of self-organized systems. Also, there's a reason for why at a quantitative state, the torque expression should be equal to the sum total of the gradient of gravitational effective. But I won't go into details now, but this is sort of another evidence that the classical theory failed. Other astrophysical implications from this theory, the damping of the wave, the similar energy injection not only to the stars but also to the interstellar medium to feel the turbulence and to produce a large amount. Also, the cluster galaxies and the fielding of nuclear activity and to feel the active nuclei. There's also many cosmological implications too, which I won't go into. So the conclusions of this talk. So this potential density phase shift is an important concept underlying the galaxy of secular evolution. So as we have shown, the stellar mass accretion enabled by the collective process is likely to be even more important than gas flow in large buildings. The phase shift not only holds for spirals, but also for skewed bars as well. The bell-shaped torque coupling actually is an indication that the nature of these spiral bar patterns are modes. They are not transient waves. We do see transient features. When there are transient features, the phase shift actually becomes not so well organized. So the transient feature in morphology and in phase shift plots, they actually go hand in hand. But these transient patterns are the minorities. Also, we found many different classes of bars. There are slow bars, fast bars, and those super fast bars that are invalidating the classical passive orbit analysis. So we're now in the process of conducting a systematic study of galaxy morphological transformation rates using this work. So this work will give us the opportunity to assess the role of secular evolution process in informing the synthesis. Thank you.